Hello students, how are you? Now today I am going to start a poem named Ode to the West Wind, written by P.B. Shelley. Now let's begin the poem summary. Ode is a short poem written in a rapid and irregular meter, fit to be sung or recited. P.B. Shelley was the visionary idealist of English Romanticism and its most ecstatic lyric singer. He had great love for freedom. These ideas were derived from William Godwin. Such ideas were connected with the study of Greek poetry and Platonic philosophy. He had desired to reform the world and all who knew him. He was the least selfish man, motivated always by the highest integrity. Shelley remained constant to his faith in the progress and perfectibility of man. Once tyranny and cruelty had been removed and man's reason and love substituted, then the soul of the universe, the spirit of love, should be revealed. This is the theme that runs through all his work. In his shorter poems, Shelley achieves a rare combination of prophetic message, precision of imagery, and captivating melody. Something of the same tone infused the poem Adonis, a pastoral elegy. Here the poet laments the death of Keats. Arnold's picture of Shelley as the beautiful and ineffectual angel beating in the void, his luminous wings in vain, is a narrow judgment even on his poetry. And his prose is clear, vigorous, and brilliant. Certainty, never ineffectual or in a void. Yet we can see Arnold's point. Shelley moved in a world of abstract ideas without reference to practical consideration of everyday world. He was utterly without a sense of proportion. He was without a sense of humor. Shelley's command of the sound effects of his verse, short of marvelous. To this melody, he brought other varieties of greatness, a sense of form, intensity, and sensuousness. His images give concrete pictures, though they deal with insubstantial things like wind, dead leaves, or an enchanted boat, which is like a sleeping swan, thus float. His idealism gave his verse a rhapsodic quality. He was dead by being drowned while outsailing. An ode is a musical poem expressing sad thoughts of the poem. In the very beginning of the poem, the poet writes, "Wild west wind." The poet takes the west wind to be wild, fierce, terrible, and forceful. The poet has all praise for the power and force of the west wind. With the rush of the west wind, the dead and the faded leaves of trees and plants swiftly fall down. These are also driven away like ghost with the power of magic of the enchanter. The seeds of different plants and trees are driven away hither and thither. With the sprinkle of rain, these seeds will sprout. The poet takes the west wind to be the harbinger or messenger of rain, fire and hail. The west wind blows high up in the sky. The blue sky is like an ocean, and floating clouds appears like leaves of trees. The poet has all praise of the strength and power of the west wind. He finds tyranny and injustice and sufferings in the world. The poet very much wants the force and power of the west wind. He even wants to become swift cloud to fly with the west wind. The poet wants the very force and the power of the west wind in his poetry. The condition of the world is of slavery and suffering. The whole humanity is chained. Human beings in the world are in agony, tyranny, and sufferings from the surface of the earth. Now, the poet is eager to spread in this world his revolutionary thoughts. The poet in this poem gives an optimistic message to mankind. He says, if winter comes, the spring cannot be far behind. This means, if life at present is surrounded by sufferings and sorrow, good days of freedom, joy and happiness are surely to follow. The poet in this poem says that he falls upon the thorns of the life and bleeds. But the final note of the poem is strongly positive and optimistic. Some stanzas of the poem are vague, like bad romantic poetry. But the poem on the whole is good, positive, and revolutionary. Now, students, after finishing this poem, I shall see you in the next poem. Till then, bye. Thank you.